So we met briefly in the morning. I'll just quickly walk you through the projects that you can choose relating to IIT Bombay X. So the first programming projects are the main ones. We have two DevOps related activities just thrown in for if somebody has an interest and would like to opt for those. But mainly we are looking for the programming related projects. So the first one is a registration and enrollment module. So basically the OpenEdX platform has a registration and enrollment module built into it. So what's the big deal about this module? So typically whenever we have a program running which uses OpenEdX platform, like the blended MOOC let's say, which requires a separate registration to the program, and then you have the IIT Bombay X platform. So you don't want people to register in multiple places to use the same functionality. So this will have a single sign-on kind of functionality where user registers in one place and all that information relating to registration is reflected in the OpenEdX platform. So the highlight of this is to use single sign-on functionality to enroll into the OpenEdX platform from an external platform or another application. The other highlight is to use APIs for accessing the functionality. So the OpenEdX platform doesn't have any pre-canned APIs which can be used by external applications to interface with the OpenEdX platform. So the other thing which you can look forward to, other than Django, Python and JSON, it will have REST APIs. So service oriented architecture kind of a paradigm can be used for doing this. So those who are interested in learning a new architecture like a service oriented architecture can choose this project. Assessment building blocks. So in the morning I was talking about enhancing the assessment feature of the OpenEdX platform, which is quite basic according to us. It needs a lot of enhancement. So the idea is to create assessments which are in a layered format. So there will be multiple layers to it. The lowest layer will interface with the OpenEdX platform. The topmost layer will interface with the student, and there will be multiple layers in between which will do various functionalities. So this will help to build assessments very easily. So once you have reusable layers, a person who is developing a new type of assessment can just use the existing layers and quickly build the assessment. So few of the layers that we were thinking about, which are like reusable components, are one, we were thinking of a grid kind of a thing where typically you have certain types of assessments, or actually a grid can be used in multiple places. It could be used in games like say chess or whatever. So you have a board where you have a grid and you have either colors filled into the grid or you have some letters filled into it, like in case of a crossword puzzle kind of a question. So the grid is one of the reusable things that will be part of this project, and using the grid, then a use case to demonstrate how the grid is working will be a game of chess. So you could develop like some kind of a strategy, and then how the student is assessed for that strategy on that grid, which is presented to the student by the faculty as a assessment. The other layer is the proctoring layer. So last year the interns had done some work around a proctored exam. So in a MOOC setup, you are having students who are remotely attempting questions, right? So there is no way you can check whether the student is cheating or not. So proctoring is a way by which you can actually find out whether the student is cheating while attempting the question online. So you have a camera and you capture his whatever mugshot and all that. So that we build as a layer into the assessment framework of OpenEdX. The OpenEdX framework doesn't have any such module. So the last year's work, we hope, we don't know yet whether it is feasible, but we hope to incorporate that into the assessment framework of OpenEdX. The third one is a reporting system for the faculty. So generally now in blended MOOC also, you may have seen that there are reports available for which there is a separate system. The faculty or the institute head or coordinator logs into a separate system to see the students' performance or progress or some kind of feedback if they want to give the data relating to that. Now this is a way by which within the platform we will allow the faculty to check some reports of the student's performance so that he can he or she can improve his whatever way of teaching based on, if let's say some student is doing poorly in some more number of students are doing poorly in some topic, then that means that that topic is not clear. So the faculty needs to pay more attention to that topic. So those kind of reports can be built into the platform. So there are various ways by which you can enhance functionality, similar to what I was talking about earlier, the chess grid that allows you to create enhancements. So this is another enhancement to the platform. So all of these are relating to Django Python functionality. The last one is a Excel sheet assessment. I mentioned that like one of our partners is IIMB. So IIM Bangalore is offering courses relating to, say, accounts. So they had a requirement whereby students should be able to upload a balance sheet as a response to a assessment. So, and the system should be able to automatically grade that assessment. So that kind of functionality again is not there in OpenEdX. So this is an enhancement to allow faculty to do a auto grading based on an Excel sheet upload. So yeah, and the other two are the DevOps related ones. One is to install various components of OpenEdX. So you will require technologies like either Docker or Ansible, Vagrant, all of these. So if anybody has an interest in that, you could choose that. And the other thing are some shell scripts for some frequently used functions, either for continuous integration or the GitHub repository relating to that, some advanced functionality that we want to build. What can you hope to achieve? Okay, so on the IIT BombayX platform, you will get to implement the complete SDLC of a project. So this is what you will not generally get to do if you go for an internship, say in industry. In industry, you will typically be given a very small module. The design would be done, lower level design is done, some part of the coding is done, and they will give you some tiniest thing that they can break the thing into and give it to you because you are intern. And if you are able to implement, fine, they'll use it, most probably they'll not. But this will have the complete SDLC, so right from requirements to some extent to developing, testing, unit testing, integration testing. Like, we have always had a complete installation in place by the interns whenever they have gone. We never have people doing like their parts of it and nothing is working with each other. So it's a complete end-to-end working system. So you will get to do that. Then of course, I was talking about open source technologies. You will get to work on open source. You will get to learn on the go. So within 2 months, you will learn a new technology as well as implement it right up to the end. You get to work on a production ready and live system. If you deliver something that's good enough to be put into production, it will be put into production. If not, you can always have your own Git repository where you can put your stuff and show it to your recruiters or whoever. Of course, this is what we will get out of it also. Make a demonstrable and meaningful contribution to the education sector in the country. So if your work gets used, you can always say that this is something that you had built and it is helping other students in some way. And the confidence to deliver a complete system. So I've always had students who have at the beginning of the project come to me saying that, ma'am, we are scared, I don't think I will be able to do it. And the end of it, these are the people who are fighting to present on the day of the final presentation because they are so proud of what they have done. So that's what I think you'll gain.